Hello, my dear friends. Single and Unique Platform welcomes you in this current affairs show. Today is 2nd September 2018 and the current affairs of this day will be discussed in this show. So first of all, let's see what happened in the history on this day. On this day in the year 1946, the Government of India was formed headed by Jawaharlal Nehru as the Vice President with all the powers of Prime Minister. So let's discuss the current affairs. As you all know, the 18th Asian Games are ongoing in Jakarta. Jakarta is the capital city of Indonesia. Mascot of these games is Bin Bin Kaka and Atung. Let me give some basic information of Indonesia. President of Indonesia is Joko Widodo. Currency of Indonesia is Indonesian Rupiah. Next, we will discuss the India's stance at these games. India at Asian Games. Indians who won medals on 1st September 2018 are Amit Panghal, who is a well-known boxer, has won gold medal. Men's hockey team won bronze medal by defeating Pakistan 2-1. Other medals won by Pranav Bardhan, Shivnath Sarkar, who won gold medal in the event bridge, which has been introduced in this very year, that is 2018. India, total number of medals won by India are 69. In these, 15 are gold, 24 are silver and 30 bronze. With this medal tally, India stands at the 8th position in these ongoing games. First position has been occupied by China. First question of this current affairs show is, in which country did Ayush Ministry inaugurated 4th International Ayurveda Congress? The country in which it has been inaugurated is Netherlands. Let me give some basic information about Netherlands. Capital of Netherlands is Amsterdam. Currency of Netherlands is Euro, and there is also one other currency, that is US dollar. Next question, question number 2 from the current affairs is, who has been conferred with the new chairmanship of BIMSTEC? The country which has been conferred with the new chairmanship of BIMSTEC is Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is the current country which has been conferred with the new chairmanship of BIMSTEC. Capital of Sri Lanka is Colombo, is considered as the commercial capital, and Sri Jayawardenapura Kotte is considered as the administrative capital. The BIMSTEC is a group of 7 countries which was constituted in the year 1997. There are 7 members in this. So the members are B. There are 2 members with the letter B, that these are Bhutan and Bangladesh, and I for India, M for Myanmar, S for Sri Lanka, T for Thailand, and there is one other member, Nepal, which you can remember without any acronym. So next information is about Sri Lanka. President of Sri Lanka is Maithripala Sirisena. Prime Minister of Sri Lanka is Ranil Wickremesinghe. Next question is, which is India's largest payment bank launched by our Prime Minister? The largest payment bank launched by our Prime Minister is India Post Payment Bank, that is IPPB. The MD and CEO of this bank is Suresh Kumar Shetty. Next question is, who has been conferred with Raman Magsessy Award, Asia's Nobel Prize? It has been also named as Asia's Nobel Prize from India. There are 2 Indians who have won this prestigious award, and those are, first, Dr. Bharat Vatwani, who is a well-known psychiatrist. Second is Sonam Wangchuk, an innovator and educationist from Leh Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir. Next question is, who has been appointed as the new chairman of IBA, that is Indian Banks Association, and he is none other than Mr. Sunil Mehta for the year 2018 and 19. Next question is India Moving, History of Migration is a book written by whom, and it has been written by Chinmay Tambe. Next question is Coffee Chain Costa has been bought by which business firm? It has been bought by Coca-Cola for $5.1 billion. Next question in the series is between which two cities India and Nepal inked an MOU, that is Memorandum of Understanding for railway line, and it has been inked for Bihar's Raxol city to Kathmandu in Nepal. Kathmandu is the capital city of Nepal and KP Sharma Oli is the Prime Minister of Nepal. Next question is which two telecom sector has completed their merger? The two telecom sectors who has completed their merger are Vodafone India and Idea Cellular, and they will be combinedly known as Vodafone India, and they now has become the country's largest telecom operator with a subscriber base of over 408 million. So that's all in this current affairs show. Thanks for watching it. Do share and subscribe.